Hello there, and welcome to Ms.RedNebula's Planko Tips, Thememaker's Toolkit Edition. In the last video, I covered the base color and how to get rid of that shininess that appears on in-game Planet Coaster Toolkit items by default. This time, I'm going to cover the two ways you can control the shininess of your object, as well as how to make it look metallic. They're called the Specular Workflow and the Metalness Workflow. You can use one or the other, but not both. Both of these work in conjunction with the Roughness and Smoothness maps. As we discussed in the last video, roughness and smoothness are basically identical except inverted, so an all-white smoothness map is 100% glossy, where an all-white roughness map is 100% matte. For the sake of simplicity, I'm just going to talk about using roughness maps in this video, but know that you have the option to use either one. A roughness map controls how shiny your object is, while the specular and metalness maps both are used to control the color of the reflections coming off of the object. A neutral, dark gray reflection creates the look of a non-metallic object, whereas a colored reflection creates the look of metal. Despite the name, you can use both metalness or specular to create a metallic-looking object. They just do it in two different ways. Let's talk about metalness first. The suffix for a metalness map in the toolkit is _MT. Metalness is a grayscale map. Black sections of the map are non-metal, gray sections are dirty or imperfect metals, and white sections are pure metals. The color reflected in the final object is that of your object's base color, or _BC, map. Here are some examples using the metalness workflow. To make your object look like it's made of shiny, pure gold, use a yellow-orange base color, a black roughness map, and a white metalness map. For dirty, rusted iron, your base color would be mottled gray with touches of dirt and rust, your roughness map would be a dark gray with lighter gray spots where the rust doesn't shine as much, and your metalness map would be a variety of gray tones, lighter where the metal shows through, darker or almost black where the grunge has obscured it. A blue plastic object would have a blue base color, a light gray roughness map, because plastic often has a little bit of shine to it, and the metalness map would be black or omitted altogether. Finally, an object made of stone will have a mottled gray base color, a mottled but almost completely white roughness map, and again, the metalness would be black or omitted. To see some objects I created using the metalness workflow in-game, look up my Mylar balloons in the workshop. Now, we'll talk about how specular maps work. You might see these referred to as a reflection map in some cases if you're downloading textures from websites. The suffix for a specular map in the toolkit is _SP. A specular map works very differently from a metalness map and is a little more complicated. The specular map's job is to say what color the reflection on an object will be, which means it can have color data. In a specular workflow, your base color map will be the appropriate color of your object for non-metallics, but will usually be completely black for metallics because the color will come from the specular map. Non-metallic objects are usually dark gray or black on a specular map, whereas metallic objects will be whatever color the metal is. Like I said, a little more complicated. Here are the same examples as the metalness workflow so you can see the difference in action. For shiny, pure gold, use a completely black base color, a black roughness map, and a bright yellow-orange specular map. For dirty, rusted iron, your base color is mostly black, but with flecks of color where the rust is. The roughness map will be dark gray with lighter gray spots where the rust isn't as shiny, and the specular map will be mostly light gray with dark speckles where it's rusted over, and some reddish sections where the rust still has a slightly metallic sheen. A blue plastic object would have a blue base color, a light gray roughness map for a little shine, and the specular map would be dark gray. You don't want it to be completely black as that would mean no color is being reflected at all, thus the object would be matte regardless of the roughness map. And finally, an object made of stone would have a mottled gray base color, a mottled but almost completely white roughness map, and a very dark gray, almost black specular map. It's best not to omit the specular map in these examples, though, because it can make the base color of the object look more vibrant, like I showed in the last video. Another fun thing with specular maps is that you can play around with a base color that does not match the reflection color, thus creating an iridescent look. So how do you decide which one to use? Let's look at the pros and cons of each. Metalness is more intuitive. All of your color information is on your base color map. Metalness can also be more efficient, as a grayscale map has a smaller file size than a full color map. On the other hand, specular can be more versatile, allowing for effects you can't do with a metalness map. Specular also makes the colors of non-metallic objects much more vibrant than you can get otherwise. So it's up to you which workflow you decide to use, but I hope this has given you enough information to get started. In the next video, we'll go over using a normal map to make your object appear to have bumps, ridges, and other detail that are not part of your model. And that's it for this tutorial. Feel free to like or comment, and if you want random updates from my Planet Coaster exploits, subscribe. If you enjoy what I do and are interested in supporting the channel, check out my Patreon. In addition to helping me out, you can also get fun perks like sneak peeks, voting on future projects, or being the first to see new videos. A big thank you to my current patrons. That's all for now. Bye!